Hi, YouTubers. SilverReady1 here. I just wanted to go over a quick rundown of the 90% silver coins. That seems to be one of the most popular ways to buy silver bullion nowadays. I just wanted to kind of go over some of the more popular versions and what is or could be the best deal in 90% silver coins. The first one we have here is a Morgan dollar. These are fairly popular. These have a lot of numismatic value, and that's one of the more popular 90% silver coins. So, sorry about that. Those were made from 1878 to, I believe, 1921. And then you have the peace dollar. Oops, let me get this on camera here. There we go. That's another 90% silver dollar. A peace dollar was the last full 90% silver dollar made for circulation. The next is the half dollars, and we have the Walking Liberty half dollar. And before that we have the Barber half, which is 90% silver also. Barber halves generally have a lot more numismatic value, as do the Walking Liberties. If they're in good condition. Next is the Franklin half dollar, which is 90% silver as well. And the Kennedy half dollar, the only 90% Kennedy half dollar for circulation was the 1964 Kennedy half dollar. The 65 through 70 were 40% silver, the ones for circulation. There were some proof issues that were 90% silver, but those aren't common. Those were later on. Next, we have the Barber Quarter. I'll figure this out. 90% silver, Barber Quarter. And after that, we have the Standing Liberty Quarter, which is also 90% silver. And Washington Quarters were actually made of 90% silver from 1932 to 1964. From 1965 on, they're just clad. No silver content at all from 1965 on. So big difference in value between a 1965 and a 1964 quarter. Next we have a Barber Dime. And these are easy to identify, as you can see. These were all made and designed by the same guy. I think it was Joseph Barber. But the half dollar, the quarter, and the dime were all the same. I guess there wasn't a lot of imagination as far as coin design back then, but anyway, at least they were silver, right? And of course, the Mercury dime. Mercury dimes were made from 1916 to 1945, I believe, or 45. And then the silver Roosevelt dimes, which are made from 1946, I want to say 46 to 1964. And of course, that was the last 90% silver dime, was the 1964 Roosevelt dime. Anyway, that's basically the pretty common coinage. The best value, I believe, out of all of these are the dimes. You will pay approximately 21 times face value for these 90% silver coins at current spot prices, maybe 22-23%, you know, times face. So for a Mercury dime, you should be paying about $2.10, maybe $2.20, in that ballpark, when silver's in the you know, $29 to $31 range. Same with the Roosevelt dimes. Up here, these have a little more numismatic value, the Morgan dollars and the Peace dollars. And the Barber coins, if they're in good condition, they have more numismatic value. You're going to pay more for those. So even an average Morgan dollar is going to run you probably about 25 to 26 times face. Same with the Peace dollars. They're just a little bigger and flashier. People tend to like them more, but you're not actually getting a better deal. If you're paying $2.10 for a Mercury or Roosevelt dime, it's a much better deal. Plus, they're easily divisible. If you can decide how much you want to sell, you know, it's just much easier to deal with, I think. and you can get better deals on the dimes. And 10 dimes is the same weight as a silver dollar. So if you're paying $21 for a dollar's worth of dimes, and you're paying $26 for a big, pretty impressive silver dollar, which is the better value? Anyway, I'll go over some other silver coins and uncommon non-circulated issues. And anyway, I'll talk to you later. Thanks.